security at the airport, and you couldn't argue that we're all just like so much safer. But there's another side of that that we don't obviously go into, like, well, what if we do that to get there? So that's a little bit of the point of view from the people that are in opposition. There are social factors that need to be addressed. There's democracy, there's this kind of interaction that is promised, and then too inconvenient, and sort of on the side. That answers your question.
Back to the foreign investment. I heard that George Soros is heavily investing into Brazil soybeans.
George Schultz?
Soros.
Oh, Soros. Oh,
Soros.
It's possible. I mean, I haven't read that, but yeah.
I had a question for you.
Okay.
Are you looking also at the two states that lost all that water? Because at that point that it's diverted,
right,
it's still Pernambuco. But then there is Sergipe and Alagoas, who shared the river.
Right.
And are not, another statement would be to say that they are not among the most politically powerful states in the country. What is especially ecologically happening there?
Right, that slide that I had with the pollution was from Sergipe, I believe.
Because without the volume of the fresh water coming in, the ocean has been invading more and more. And there is occurring a complete change in biological terms. The fish are becoming the fish that the riverside population depended on for food are disappearing.
Yeah, I touched on that a little bit in my paper, and I didn't bring it up as much here today. But I could have written five or ten pages about that issue, as well as 5 or 10 issues, about each of the various issues that people have against this project. I mean, I really had to do sort of a potpourri because there's Indian rights, there's the Pilambu rights, there's the environmental degradation upstream, there's the environmental degradation downstream, the impact on the land, the impact on the labor force. I mean, there's as many different ways to look at it as there are opposition groups to the project. So, yeah, it's a very good point.
No more questions, and thank you both. Congratulations.
Yeah, I touched on that a little bit in my paper, and I didn't bring it up as much here today. But I could have written five or ten pages about that issue, as well as 5 or 10 issues, you know, about each of the various issues that people have against this project. I mean, I really had to do sort of a potpourri, because there's Indian rights, there's the Lumber rights, there's the, you know, the environmental degradation upstream, there's the environmental degradation down.
That lost all that water. Because at that point that's diverted,
right,
it's still got the move. But then there is Sergipe and Alagoas, who shared the river.
Right.
And are not, an understatement would be to say that they are not among the most politically powerful states in the country. Mm-hmm. What is especially ecologically?
Right, that slide that I had with the pollution was from Sergipe, I believe.
Because without the volume of the fresh water coming in, the ocean has been invading more and more. And there is occurring a complete change in biological terms. The fish are becoming fish that the riverside population depended on for food are disappearing.
Back to the foreign investment. I heard that George Soros is heavily investing into Brazil soybeans.
George Schultz?
Soros.
Oh, Soros. Oh,
Soros.
It's possible. I mean, I haven't read that, but yeah.
I had a question for.
Okay.
Are you looking also at the two states that
security at the airport? And you couldn't argue that we're all just like so much safer. But there's another side of that that we don't obviously need to go into. Like, well, what if we do to get there? So that's a little bit of the point of view from the people that are in opposition. It's, there are social factors that need to be addressed. There's democracy. There's this kind of interaction that is promised. And then two inconveniences.